Hello and welcome to another video of this coaching part. And this time we will talk about, we are still in the macro area strategy, and then for the composition we will talk about positioning ultimates. Basically what I want to tell you in this part is how you as a coach can set your focus, how you as a coach can set your focus to positioning and to ultimate usage. Like what should you look at? If Genji comes to you and says like, "Hey," or like one of your players, and he plays Genji and says like, "Hey, I always use Blade, but I cannot really, I don't know, I always fuck it up or anything like this." So, what is the thing you want to look at if you think about ultimates? And ultimates, mostly I already went over in the last video where I called up, talked about the fight planning and ult planning. So all of these things, okay, how do we use the ults, when do we use the ults and stuff should be already included in the fight plan. That we use it, for example, secondary or first or something, we open the fight with it, things like this. And then if you talk about ults briefly, the thing you want to take a look at as a coach is, they usually listen. Like if they listen to the plan, the fight planner does, and if they execute it the right way. And executing the right way obviously has a big variety of meanings. Like for example, as a Mei, if you play against D.Va and you want to use your Mei ult, then obviously you want to freeze the D.Va first or wall her off so she cannot eat it. Things like this. These are going more into micro circus. So basically, if you talk about ult usage in a macro perspective, you want to listen to the fight planner, and you want to see if the players are listening to this plan and execute it in the right way, like from the attention here, from the attention. Like if they, how can I say it? Like it's not about the micro part if the Genji played really makes 6k or not. It's more about, does the Genji activate his blade at this at the exact like at the right time? Is he going for the tank or is he going for the Ana first? Obviously, this like it has a, it all goes together a little bit with the micro circus of, is he doing it the right way and stuff. But I hope you get the thought. What I like the thought, you can follow my thought process here. That I mean, you as a coach, if you think about a macro, if you want to look over the whole team and want to see if there's anything you can improve in the ult usage, want to check if the Genji or like if the ultimates are used in the at this at a good time, and also the intention of the ults is correct. And obviously for this you just need understanding of the meta, and you also need understanding of how do you play this composition, which comes basically back again to what we did in another video, the strengths, weaknesses, and win condition. You need to know what is the win condition of this composition, how you want to play it, and the ultimates you use mostly want to support this win condition, or they want to negate the strengths, these weaknesses. Think about Lucio Barrier, for example. Lucio Barrier perfectly to negate the weakness of sustainability of a dive. So yeah, this would be the attention of a ultimate, and then you basically want to see. And fo or focus on, you could focus on, are the ultimates used for this intention, or are they used in a different way? A good example, I guess, is we stay at dive, like this last example, and then we go for the next part. We stay at dive and we have like cyber dive, and we beat early, like we beat and then blade. So, and that intention of our Lucio is okay, he wants to beat to blade. Like he wants to save or like kind of save our Genji against incoming damage because obviously they will try to attack him so that he's safe to use the Genji blade. And maybe the team also thinks this is the right call, and even the fight planners calls it like, "Hey, we beat first and then we jump in." Now you as a coach should think about this critically, and you think like you look at every decision your team makes. And then think about this, and is it actually a good idea to kind of beat first and then play it, or even beat and then dive? And if I like, obviously this goes a lot in detail, but I would say no, it's not the best way to do it. It's not the most optimal way, because beat, like the moment you use beat, you have the most amount of shields, and the more time it goes over, obviously it loses value. That means you actually want to have the beat when it really matters, and it doesn't matter when you are on your side. Like, you only need the beat after you jump in. And even if you jumped in, you do not need a beat immediately, because then you have Diva Matrix, you have Winston Bubble, you have Genji Deflect, all of these things. You want to beat, like, first you can use abilities. You want to beat after your team is still in a fight and the abilities are already done. They already used all of the abilities. Then you want to have the beat. But if you beat already here at the start, then the beat is already done. Like, the beat effect will not be as significant anymore. So in this case, I would say as a coach, okay guys, I see the intention of you that you want to beat it was safe or to give the Genji more sustain, but it's not necessary because of point A, B, and C. So we beat after this. Obviously, this information you might not want to give it. Like, you want to give it in a one review session and not between the maps, or if this is the only thing you can talk about it. But yeah, this would be kind of one thing where you as a coach can think about if we talk about ult usage. So then let's talk also about positioning. And positioning, again, it's this is not positioning. Positioning. It obviously depends a lot on the composition, so I cannot really say much about this. Comes back obviously again to what composition you play. So how is your what is your attention, what is your win condition, and do you use it accordingly? Do you position well enough with angles? Do, for example, if your win condition is spam, or your composition is a spam composition, then you want to take a look if your DPS take different angles, if they stay together. If they stay together, why do they stay together? And all these things. So it's more about that's like you want to compare the team. Like, do you want to see, okay, does the team take the optimal way to approach this from like a macro perspective, in the rotation or positioning side? If you're playing spam against dive, do we all stay together or we split up? Maybe nobody made this call, but if do you have a certain matchup, then you need to position yourself in a like accordingly, and this is something you as a coach can also focus on. That not only the strength, like not only if they kind of play it right, that for example as a don't know as a dive, they do not just walk into the enemies and try to poke them down or something, that they actually also jump to them, so that this would be more okay. Do we play our comp out well? But another thing would be, okay, if we actually want to jump into them, do we kind of position us in different locations, or does the Winston jump with the D.Va to or the D.Va jumps with the Winston together? Does the Genji takes another angle so it doesn't get the spam damage or anything like this? Is the Ana after the dive in a position where she can get value, where she maybe can even shoot behind the shield or heal behind the shield? Things like this. These are positional things which are obviously individual, like everybody has his own individual positioning, but is the team at the start of a fight set up in the right way according to the matchup you have? And this could be another concept of you, like of what you want to what you could focus on during a scrim or in a board review or something. And yeah, I hope this kind of four concepts gave you a kind of a little bit of an idea what you as a coach need to focus on, and where you can put your like your yeah where you want to focus on. Obviously there are way more things you can like, or way more detailed concepts also you can think about during a scrim or in a what you or something, but these are just four examples of, I think, mostly the basics. What you want to look for and where you want to see, or where you can search for improvement in your team. Then thank you for watching and see you next time.